Hey, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Inside Microsoft Teams. I'm your host, Stephen Rose, and thanks for joining us today. One of the questions I get asked most at conferences is, what is Microsoft Viva? And I'll start to say, well, it's Microsoft Viva Sales. And it's like, no. Just what is Microsoft Viva? Can you give us a solid answer? And I thought, I know the perfect person to do that. So we're going to dig into over the next few weeks, the different modules. But I thought, there's no one better than Mr. Scott Smith to walk through what is Viva and kind of understand it from the top level. Scott, how are you?
I'm doing well. How about yourself, Stephen?
I'm doing good. So, what is Viva? We announced it at Ignite last year. We had already had some of the different modules, things like that. So, at the highest level, what is Microsoft Viva?
Yeah, so Microsoft Viva is a digital employee experience platform that's really built on Microsoft technology, Microsoft 365, and lends itself really well to the Microsoft ecosystem. It integrates with the graph as well as the other parts of your Microsoft investments. So it makes it really easy to plug employee experience into the day-to-day tools like Microsoft Teams that your employees might already be using. So it's a plethora of different applications all designed to really help employees be productive, focus on well-being, connect with each other, engage with each other in this modern work world of hybrid work.
All right. We'll talk about the individual apps in a second, but this could be things like, hey, reminding me that I have important training to do. It can be things like blocking out some focus time because I have a ton of meetings, but there's no time for me to go back and do the action items or suggest people I may want to reconnect with that I haven't talked to in a while. It's those sort of things. It's sort of looking at how I'm working and saying, here's some things that can help you or that are important to you or that you need to be aware of. Is that a fair assessment, kind of at a high level?
Yeah, exactly. In addition, we have other pieces of the portfolio like Viva Connections that allow for a modern internet solution built right into your Microsoft Teams experience. Viva Goals, which really helps with the OKRs and goal setting across the organization, as well as some new applications that are coming out across 2023 as well. So it really has grown into a full end-to-end employee experience suite designed to really hit every point of the employee's journey from joining an organization through maturing within an organization to really help them make sure that they are productive and that we're focusing on well-being no matter where they are.
Well, you have some slides to break this down. So let's take a look at those slides and talk about the individual modules, of which I think there are 126 at this point or something like that. How many are there now?
But yep.
Six? Is it six that we're at now?
There's six right now, and we're releasing a couple more through the calendar year 2023 as well.
All right. Let's take a look at the slides.
Stephen, as you alluded to, Microsoft Viva was actually announced almost 2 years ago to the day in 2021. It initially started with four applications within the platform: Viva Connections, Viva Insights, Viva Topics, and Viva Learning, each for specific needs of the employee experience at that time. But as we've really grown over, say, 2022, we've added more capabilities to the portfolio, including OKR setting through Viva Goals, as well as community building through Viva Engage. And then through 2023, we're also going to be releasing a few new applications: Viva Amplify, which helps support corporate-wide communication through multiple endpoints; Viva Pulse, which it allows for point-in-time surveys and making sure that your employees are doing well and staying productive; Answers in Viva, which really focuses on aggregating the right answers from experts across your organization, as well as a bunch of more capabilities coming to the platform as well.
And we just talked about Viva Sales this week and the adding in of AI to Outlook as part of that. Is that also part of these rollouts and things that we're doing?
Exactly. So this kind of gives a left to right horizontal view of what Microsoft Viva really is trying to do. It's focused from an employee experience standpoint, really on four key areas: connection, insight, purpose, and growth. And then, as you alluded to, Stephen, we are also focused on role-based experience as well for those specific types of roles that need help. And that's where Viva Sales comes into play.
All right. Here's my next question. This is the one that I get asked most often, which is it spying on me? Is it tracking and telling my boss everything I'm doing, when I'm logging in, when I'm moving my mouse and all of that sort of stuff? And, the answer is no. But I thought I would love for you to talk to this and explain to people why it's not and how it's not.
Yeah, so Viva is really designed to leverage the privacy protocols that are already put into place in Microsoft 365, as well as what your organization fine-tunes within, say, the Viva Insights solution as well. So it's not designed to capture exactly what you're doing at any given moment and feed that information to your manager to tell you, hey, Scott hasn't been checking his email today. What it's really designed to do is look at information in aggregate across your organization and identify trends to help employees be more productive and focus on well-being. So I think you touched earlier on focus time being a big aspect of Viva. And that's what that data and aggregation will do is it will help look at your, say, week ahead and say, it looks like you have a bunch of meetings and you could probably use a little bit of time in between those meetings to, you know, go to the bathroom, eat some lunch, catch up on emails. Let's go ahead and block some of that time for you so that you can really focus on getting your work done and capture a little bit of that employee well-being as part of your day-to-day life as well. So it's not spyware. It's not designed to track you. It's really just designed to make sure that, at least from a Viva Insights standpoint, that it's really helping you, prodding you along to be really focused on the well-being aspects of work as well.
Okay. Tell me if I'm right or wrong on this, because this is my impression when I've given some examples of saying it will take a look at my boss's team as an aggregate, not at me. And it will tell my boss, hey, you know what? You're sending out a lot of emails after hours that's forcing people to work late at night. Or 70% of the meetings that your team is in, they're multitasking. They're in Teams, they're in email or other things at once to really help to kind of take a look at that, to look at whether it's by group sales marketing or by a manager, but there's no way for the CIO or for HR or someone like that to take a look at an individual person, even though I get individual reports. Is that correct?
Yeah. So what we really do is we try and focus on the aggregation at the group level, exactly what you're referring to, Stephen. We don't want to be saying Scott individually is not checking his emails at this specific time. But I think you gave a great example, Stephen. One of the great capabilities of Viva Insights, for example, is it can let you know when you're crafting an email to someone who is not working in the same time zone and let you know, like, hey, you're sending an email outside of their time zone. Probably worthwhile to either delay send this, which it can automatically do through Viva Insights, or maybe just send that during your both of your business hours.
I had that pop up in Teams the other day. It told me that I was not sending a Teams message within the working hours for this person and that I still want to send it, which I thought was great because it's a member of my team who's in Paris this week, and it even took that into account, which was cool. Exactly. Now, Viva seems like disparate apps that don't connect, and managing apps can be difficult because there is no sort of single point of management. I know that we've combined our management solution, that we've consolidated it. And I think that would be a really great thing for this audience to talk about what we've done to make it easier to manage and secure Viva apps within the admin center. I think you have a demo to show us. So could we switch over to that and take a look at that?
Yeah, exactly. So you touched right on it here that we really wanted to focus today on the admin experience. We've really heard and tried to take in feedback from our IT administrators that have leveraged Viva today to make it as easy as possible to set up, deploy, and configure all of these underlying applications right within the Microsoft Admin Center like you would of any of your other Microsoft investments as well. So yeah, let's hop right into the demo, Stephen. Yeah, so excellent. So what you're seeing here is the Microsoft Admin Center. So what you can do as an IT administrator now is just search for, say, the keyword Viva. And right up at the top, you'll see that nice icon for the Microsoft Viva suite. And once you drill into there, it's pretty straightforward to see all of the applications your organization has a license to. So right away, you'll see, based off of the plan type you've had, what applications of the Viva suite your organization is licensed for. So it makes it really easy, again, to see that left to right horizontal view of all of the Viva investments your organization might have. And what's great here is you can also just go ahead and manage licenses and roles just like you would all of your other Microsoft investments right here as well. So if you click into manage licenses, it'll take you right to the licensing page for the rest of your Viva products as well as the Microsoft portfolio at writ large. Same thing with the roles as well for Viva specific roles. So again, we're really trying to make sure it's easy for IT administrators to just go to one place for Microsoft Viva, set up the roles, set up the licensing, and really make it easy with a one-stop shop solution. And once you've kind of managed those macro level licensing and roles, you can really see each individual app, what state they're in. Have you done any sort of granular administrative features for each one of those applications and drill right into those. So a good example, let's dive right into, say, Viva Learning, for example. So Viva Learning is a robust solution within the Microsoft Viva suite that requires a couple specific pieces of configuration. In the past, prior to this consolidated view in the Microsoft Admin Center, you're going to be pushed out to, say, a Viva Learning specific page or documentation. Now that's all housed right here within the Microsoft Admin Center. So you can see, you know, all the different pieces of underlying information that you might need to set up, administrators, learning sources. And if you ever need help, say more information, you can just click right there. It'll give you a nice little flyout of here are the documentation on the far right, different sort of content sources you can go ahead and create. Again, making it seamless in one spot. And then so if we say go back and we want to set up specific pieces of information for Viva Learning, for example, it's really easy. One thing that Viva Learning does, it takes learning content from your other LMS systems that you might have at your organization and aggregates it into one spot. Well, you can imagine from an IT administration standpoint, that can be kind of complex if you have multiple different LMS systems that your organization might have. With Viva Learning in the Mac, you can go ahead and configure all of that right here. So you can choose, say, your content providers, as well as all of the necessary credentials to get those two systems communicating with each other without ever leaving the Mac experience as well. So it makes it, again, really seamless for, say, some of these products within the Viva suite, like Learning, that require maybe feeds from other systems as well. And then what's really cool within the new Mac experience too is you can also do administration functions specifically for, say, a learning knowledge administrator right here. You can, just like other parts of Microsoft, choose the right administrator from the dropdown here and apply that permissions right here, right within the Microsoft Admin Center. Very easy for those folks then to manage the granular administration of Viva Learning specific aspects that maybe a global IT admin doesn't need to manage, that can be federated right down to them as well. So making it really easy for individuals to also grant access and control to the individuals that are going to be managing the individual parts of the applications as well. And that's really it, Stephen. We really wanted to just really focus on the fact that all of these applications are coming into one place right here with the Microsoft Admin Center, allowing our global IT admins to configure, deploy, and manage all their Viva investments in one spot, as well as grant that federated control to the right individuals across the organization, again, without leaving the experience they're used to from Microsoft.
All right, great stuff. It's awesome to see how well we've done now in bringing that whole admin center together, because it was a bit of a mess early, but it's great to see how streamlined and easy it is. So where's the best place, first of all, besides coming back for more episodes as we'll dive into these individual modules in general, to go learn more about Viva and to find training for their end users?
Yeah, so the number one place is learn.microsoft.com. There's a whole page there about setting up deploying, as well as what's really important, especially when you're thinking about a suite like Viva, is that it's not just the technology that solves some of these problems as well. It's the process and the business decision makers that need to be part of this as well. So there's step-by-step information about not only how to deploy from an IT admin standpoint, but also work with your business stakeholders to prioritize the right rollout of the different applications and make sure that you're really getting the business value out of it, part and parcel with your investment within the Viva.
Driving awareness to increase adoption. Absolutely.
Exactly.
Now, I know you're going to do a blog that'll dig into more of the resources and things that are out there, because I know a lot of folks are going to do that. And we would love to have folks, you know, again, reach out to us, let us know what questions you have as we continue to go through these different modules and talk about new ones as they come out. Scott, final thought before we say goodbye to everybody.
It's exciting times here at Microsoft Viva. We continue to expand the portfolio. Feel free to work with your business decision makers on the right tools that are right for them. And come check out Viva Suite and see how it can those tools can help your organization, help your employees be more productive in the hybrid world of work, as well as focus on their well-being.
Hopefully, this helps you to get your arms around Viva, why it's important, and what it can do for end users. And I will tell you, as a company, it has dramatically changed how our management looks at employees, what their expectations are of us, and allowing us to have a much better work-life balance because of this. So I can't speak any more highly about this tool. So Scott, thanks for joining us. For everybody else, thanks for joining us on this episode of Inside Microsoft Teams. We will see all of you very soon. Thanks so much.